Hey everyone, I'm creating a video series about the FlipBoard. The FlipBoard's a MacroPad created by MakeItHackin. I enjoy teaching about the Flipper, and MakeItHackin and I decided to team up on the FlipBoard. I plan on releasing a bunch of tutorials over the next few months focused on the FlipBoard. Also, don't forget to join my Discord server for some giveaways provided by MakeItHackin. This video is about the FlipKeyboard application. We'll look at the existing features, and then we'll make our own customizations. For example, the green button opens a command window and does a directory, and the red button formats the drive. These apps keep evolving, so let us know in the comments what features you want. Let's get started. The FlipBoard README includes all the setup instructions, but let me know if you want me to make a video on that. We're going to go into Configure. And then we'll go down and choose Action 4, which is the third button. And here you can see we can choose the press color and the color when we release the button, and then the musical note to play when the button's pressed, and then the message to type when the button's clicked. And then we'll go ahead and go into that message option, hold the D for lowercase, and then I, R, and then for a space, we'll hold the underscore, and then G, and ideally we want to type a colon, but this is a limited default keyboard, and so there's no colon, so I'll just hit save. And then we'll go ahead and back out of that configuration. Then over in QFlipper, we'll go to Files, SD Card, Apps Data, FlipBoard. This is where all the FlipBoard apps are, and then we'll right-click on Keyboard and Download. We'll open the file in Notepad, scroll down to button ID 4. There's our DIR. We'll add a colon to the end of that line. And then we want the computer to press Enter, but if we pressed Enter here, we wouldn't be on the same message line anymore. So we can use the special pilcrow character, which is what I call the paragraph sign. Unfortunately, the symbol's not on our keyboard, but we can go ahead and just copy it off of this document. Or alternatively, there's an alt code here. It's Alt+0, so if you type Alt and then 20 on the numeric keypad, you'll also get the paragraph symbol. And then back in Notepad, we'll go ahead and paste that symbol after the G colon. Then we'll bring up QFlipper and our file explorer. We'll go into SD Card, Apps, Data, FlipBoard, and then we'll drag our keyboard.txt that's updated into the QFlipper app. We'll press the third button on our FlipBoard, and there's the DIR G colon. Under Applications User, FlipKeyboard, I've opened app.c. We'll go ahead and scroll down until we get to the debounced switch code. So this is the code that gets executed every time you press a button on the FlipBoard. And you can see on line 68, we update the graphical user interface, the flipper screen. And then 71, we set the colors of the lights on the FlipBoard. And then we send the keystrokes and the text message that was typed. And then finally we play a tone. So let's edit this code so that when the third and fourth button are pressed, that we type in that pilcrow character. So we'll set button 1 and button 2 to zeros so that those are up. And we'll keep button 4 and button 8 down. So line 70 is if the third and fourth buttons are pressed, then line 72 will get access to the keyboard. 73 will set a delay variable for every 50 milliseconds. Then we'll press the left Alt button. Then we'll press 2 on the keypad. Then we'll release the 2. Then we'll press 0 on the keypad. And then we'll release the 0 and the Alt. So this is the Alt+0 code that we saw in that lookup sheet. We'll do Control-Shift-B and then launch app on Flipper. And that will transfer our code over to our Flipper. So back over in Notepad, I'll go ahead and type in CLS to clear the screen. And then I'll press the third and fourth buttons on our FlipPad, and there's our pilcrow. So next I wanted to show configuring keystrokes. So we'll go down to Action 8, which is our button 4. And I'll say add a keystroke, and then I'll click on the OK button for the keystroke. And then here we can choose, you can see we have our own keyboard that we've created that has a lot more of the keys that you would normally find on a keyboard. So then here I'm going to go ahead and add another one. We'll do F4. So we have that Alt F4 to close an app. And there you go. And so now when you press the fourth button, it would close the current app that's open. So you can see we have a lot more buttons than that default Flipper keyboard. But if we go in here and we look, we do have the function keys, backspace, control, GUI, alt, the arrow keys, assist rec, and even the power button. And so let's go ahead and choose the equal sign. And then you can see if we use the arrow keys here, we actually have more options. Copy, paste, undo, find, mute, volume, help, menu buttons. There's all kinds of extra buttons that are currently not bound to our keyboard. So the final customization I want to look at was how we could change this power button to be a different key, like print screen. So the first thing we're going to do is go into our assets folder under Flip Keyboard, and we'll go down and find that power button, which is a 25 by 10 pixel. And I'll go ahead and say copy, and then I'll do a paste and we'll make a duplicate. And then we'll rename that to be the print screen 25 by 10. I'm using an extension called LunaPaint that allows me to see the images without having to open a third-party editor. Thanks to Mr. Forrest on my Discord server for teaching me about this extension. I think it's really helpful to not have to open yet another application in your workflow. So if a key is 1 wide, you get a 5 by 10 pixel. If it's 2 wide, you get a 15 by 10. And if it's 3 wide like this one, you get a 25 by 10 to try to draw. I'm going to try to draw a print screen to the best of my pixel abilities, which is not all that great. And even going slow, you can see there's a few little errors here. But luckily for us, there's also a whiteout button. Once you're happy, go ahead and hit save on the file. And then go back to your app.c file. Control-Shift-B, and then launch app on Flipper. And we're just going to use this so that it builds our code. We're not actually trying to launch the application because we haven't told it about this icon yet. So that ended up running this icons and created our Flipboard keyboard icons.c file using that new asset that we created. Next, we'll open appkeyboardlayout.h, and this has all of the keyboard and the shift keys along with the characters to show or the icons to show. So instead of power, we want to use print screen. So I'm doing control space after this P and then choose print screen. And then the last one and print screen. And then finally, we have to change those icons from power icons to print screen icons. So again, I'm doing that control space and this time we're doing print screen 25 by 10. There we go. I'm not sure why I'm seeing red squigglies. Let me know in the comments. And then when you scroll up, you have to have these same blocks of 12 for every row of 12 that we have down here. So if you add a new row for your keyboard, make sure you also add a row up above. So Control-Shift-B and launch app on Flipper, and we should have the app. Now over on our Flipper, we'll go into config, back down to action 8. We'll go down to our keystroke, and then now you can see our new print screen button is there. We'll choose the print screen button, and it says print screen. Great. And then we're going to go ahead and switch this to none and our count to 0 so that this just does a print screen. And then we'll go ahead and back out and go down to Flip Keyboard. Thanks for watching. Now you know the current state of the Flipboard app. And you know how to edit messages in Notepad, how to write custom code for the alt codes, how to create custom icons and keys for the keystrokes. And if you have feature suggestions, please let us know. We can add them to our backlog. Bluetooth support is one of the features we're thinking about, but I'd love to hear your ideas. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out on my Discord server.